हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द थर्ड लेक्चर ऑन द इंटरव्यू क्वेश्चंस। ओके, दिस लेक्चर इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। एज आई हैव टोल्ड यू दैट आई एम शेयरिंग माय एक्सपीरियंस व्हाट आई हैव फेस्ड ड्यूरिंग माय पीएचडी एडमिशन इन आईआईटीज, इन आईसर्स एंड इन इंस्टीट्यूट्स, रिसर्च इंस्टीट्यूट्स। एंड नॉट ओनली मी, आई हैव ऑल्सो आस्क्ड टू माई फ्रेंड्स, दे ऑल्सो शेयर देयर ओन इंटरव्यू एक्सपीरियंसिस। सो एवरीथिंग आई गैदर द इंफॉर्मेशन एंड आई एम प्रेजेंटिंग यू एवरीथिंग। सो माई हार्टली रिक्वेस्ट दैट यू शुड वॉच फुल वीडियो टू बीकम द मास्टर ऑफ एनी क्वेश्चंस रिगार्डिंग क्वांटम मैकेनिक्स और स्टैटिस्टिकल फिजिक्स व्हिच यू वांट टू यू मे बी यू मे फेस एट द इंटरव्यू। ओके, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। सो द फर्स्ट थिंग इज द क्वेश्चंस आईआईटी बीएचयू दे आस्क्ड प्लैंक हाइपोथेसिस, आई मीन हाउ प्लैंक्स मॉडिफाइड और हाउ प्लैंक्स give the theory of the black body radiation. So you should have a brief comment on black body radiation. What are the problems regarding the describing the classical theory regarding black body radiation, and how Max Planck overcome the limitations and found the black body radiation theory. Okay, then photoelectric effect. This is another very important question, that what is photoelectric effect? So what are the limitations of the classical explanation of the photoelectric effect? If you vary intensity, what will be the photoelectric current? If you vary the frequency, what will be the photoelectric current? Will the intensity or the frequency, what will decide the cutoff current? Okay, and Compton effect. So all will be explained by particle nature of light, that is photon. So the question was how Einstein fixed photoelectric effect with his photoelectric effect equation. Okay, so these are very in general questions, that is the how quantum physics comes to play and replace classical mechanics. Okay, so you should know the things very well. They can ask you, basically the black body radiation in IITBHU, they definitely ask you. Another thing is the wave function. Okay, what is the meaning of wave function? What are the criteria of wave function, that is single value, that is square integral? What is the meaning of that? What is the meaning of a single value wave function? What do you need the square integrable wave functions? So whatever you will tell them, you should know the physical meaning of the thing that you will answer. Another is the quantum operators and their physical meaning. That is also very important. Like, why do you calculate expectation values? What are the quantum operators like commutators? What does it mean? Means if commutator is non-zero, then what does it mean? The meaning of that commutator is non-zero means the two functions cannot be measured simultaneously at a precision limit. Okay, so they may also ask you to calculate the commutator of some function like x or b or something, any other. They can ask any commutator like x and b or any other function. So you should know how to calculate the commutators. Another is a very famous question that any IITs like IIT Gandhinagar, IIT BHU, IIT Delhi, I mean whenever you tell that quantum mechanics, I want to tell, want to be asked, whenever they ask you. So they will always ask questions from potentials and related wave functions, like the plotting of symmetry wave potential, anti-symmetric potential, linear harmonic oscillator, half harmonic oscillator. They can tell you, they can ask you plot symmetric potential and write out plot the wave function of for the ground state and write out its energy eigenvalues. Okay, and they can ask you that half harmonic oscillator, plot the wave function, what will happen at the boundary. Okay, anti-symmetric potential also they can ask you the wave function, ground state wave function, its related eigenvalues. So you have to know that from hydrogen atom also they can ask you that plot the position, what is the potential of the hydrogen atom problem, what are the eigenfunction, ground state eigenfunction of the hydrogen atom, what are the eigenvalues of the energy eigenvalue for the ground state of the hydrogen atom problem, how the alpha value can be
can be changed in case of helium or any other molecule from hydrogen. And they can also ask you that how, from the perturbation, that if you in this wooden shell you take a perturbation of the with x or something, I mean, what will be the changes in the eigenvalues. So these are very important topics that you have to know how to plot the wave functions and their potentials. And also they can ask you linear harmonic oscillator problem. The IIT teacher asked that why the ground state of the LHO is not zero, the ground state energy is not zero, because due to Heisenberg uncertainty principle. Okay, Heisenberg under uncertainty principle, so LHO is not zero, LHO ground state is not zero. So the question, the thing is that you should know all things, the potentials, that is symmetric, anti-symmetric, how to plot it, the wave functions, what happens of the psi at the boundary, and the energy eigenvalues. Okay, now come to the statistical physics. They ask you that calculate the partition function. Suppose you have two particles and three states. What will be the partition function for Maxwell's particle, means classical particles, following Maxwell's Boltzmann statistics. What will be the partition function for fermions? What will be the partition function for bosons? So you have to know the how to calculate partition function. Why do we need partition function? Because from partition function you can take energy, you can have Helmholtz free energy, you can have entropy, so you can have any information of. So partition function is very much important in statistical physics. Also they can ask you from the Bose-Einstein statistics, that is what is boson and what is Bose condensation. And they also can ask, if you tell them that solid state physics is my topic of research, will be my topic of research, the most famous question that any institute will ask you, that is how band is generated. Because in atoms, you know, from hydrogen atom also the energies are discrete. But in when the atoms we come to the molecules, the discrete energy levels will lead to the formation of the bands. So there will be no discrete energy levels but bands. In case of metals, the bands are overlapped. In case of semiconductor, the band gap is of the order of 1 electron volt. In case of dielectric, the band gap of the order of typically 5 to 7 electron volt. Okay. So how these bands are generated in molecules? So you have to know the Kronig-Penney model. You have to know each and everything about the Kronig-Penney model. So this is very famous questions that are coming from usually that asked in from quantum mechanics, statistical physics. So hopefully I can help you at some extent. Till now, happy learning and wish you all the luck.